So grammar is a for a particular language. Let us take L is a language. So grammar for L language is represented by G. For language L is equal to V S T and P. So as I explained you, V is called vertex variable or non-terminal. Okay, what is S? S is your start symbol. What is T? T is basically terminal. Or in context of the language, you can say T is basically your sigma, your alphabet. Okay. Now what is P? P is production. So let us take any grammar to understand these things is that let us take any grammar S. S goes to A, S, B, and B goes to B, B, and B goes to B. So this is the grammar. So here, what is V? What is V? Here V will be S, B. This is V. This is non-terminal, vertex or variable. For further study, we will call V as variable. Okay. So your start symbol will be S and your terminals will be A and B. This one. Yes, very good. So why you did a study? To generate the sentence of the language English. This is the reason. Here also is the same analogy is here. So we are having the language, we have to generate all the strings of the language, so we use the grammar here. So this is the thing. So now first let us see the type of grammar, then we'll take first grammar, one by one we'll take grammar. Okay. So type of grammar, in type of grammar, first we have type 3 grammar. So this is type 3 grammar. Then we have type 2 grammar. Then we have type 1 grammar. And finally we have type 0 grammar. So this is type 0 grammar, and type 0 grammar is called unrestricted grammar. Unrestricted grammar. Okay, so for type 3 grammar we have Turing machine. Okay, for type 0 grammar we have Turing machine. It is called unrestricted grammar, and type 1 grammar is called LBK. So it is type 3 grammar. It is linear bounded automata. So type 3 grammars we have LBA. Okay, and moreover it is called context sensitive grammar. So we have similarly, as for restricted grammar we have Turing machine, for context sensitive grammar we have linear bounded automata, and for type 2 grammar is called context free grammar. For this grammar we have push down automata. And this is type 3 grammar. For type 3 grammar we have finite automata, and the grammar is called regular grammar. So this is about the classification of the grammar. Now let us start with type 3 grammar. So now we have language. Moreover our language is regular language. Okay, regular language. So for this regular language we have what? We have called acceptor. What is acceptor? Acceptor is finite automata. For this regular language we have generator. What is generator? Is called generator is called grammar. For this regular language we have representer. So what is representation? Representation is your regular expression. Okay. So this is what your representation is. So we have three things with this regular language. Very important thing is that with this regular language L, we are having regular expression. With the help of regular expression, we can very easily write the grammar, regular grammar. In rest of the grammars, we do not have regular expressions, so there is a little bit difficult to write the grammar. Here it is easy to write the grammar. The language L is equal to length of a string. Language is that length of a string is equal to 2. So this is our language. And this is our terminals, or you can say alphabet. Terminals are A and B. And what will be the language? What will be the language? Your language will be, if length of a string is equal to 2, the language will be AA, AB, BA and BB. So this will be your language. So let us try to write the grammar for that. If you write the grammar for that, this is finite level, finite language. Moreover, the language has very few strings, only 4 strings. So you can write grammar directly. Let us take S as your start symbol and AA. S goes to AB and S goes to BA and F goes to DB. So these are the production of your language. This is your vertex or variable. Moreover, it is also start symbol. So this is the grammar for this language. For this language. So you can generate with this grammar, you can generate entire string or of the language. Yes or no? You can generate entire, you can start with the start symbol and you can generate entire strings of this language. So this is the way when we have very few strings. Now try to write the, you can write these production this way also, S goes to AA, AB, BA and DB. Okay, now very important thing is that we will write this grammar with the help of regular expression. So what is the regular expression for this language? Regular expression for this language will be, regular expression for this language will be A plus B and A plus B. So this will be the regular expression for this language. Let us see how, if you, it is, it, this means A plus B means A or B, this A plus B means A or B. So you, and this is the concatenation of these two things. So if you take AA, so take A from here you will get this. This is AB, you can take A from here and B from here you will get AB. You can take BA, B from here, A from here, you will get the AB. BB means you will take B amongst A and B, and from B, from these A and B, A or B, you will get this B. So this is the regular expression for this language. Now how we will write the grammar? So you can write the grammar S goes to, this is A or B. You can write in grammar as A or B. Okay. And you can write here, it is also A and B. So what you will do? You will take A, another variable A, and for this AB, you can take A or B. Or from S goes to A and A. So this is your A, this is your A, so this is your grammar. This is your grammar. This is the way to write the grammar. You will have to write the regular expression for that. So regular expression is this. Then you will have to find out the blocks. So we have find the block A plus B and A plus B. So first we write the grammar for the A plus B. So A plus B grammar will be A goes to A and F goes to A and A. So this is your grammar. So this is the way to write the language. Language will be A. F language will be epsilon A. A A A A A A A A A and so on. So this will be your language as described here. This is the regular expression, this is the actual language. So how will write the regular expression for that? So remember it is very interesting and important also the way we write the grammar. So A star. So So these are your epsilon A. This is your string. So let us take A goes to A. Okay. So we are getting this. Okay. Now you would like to get A. How you can get it? You can take A. Okay. Now you need this epsilon also. So take A goes to epsilon. So now let us see how you can get entire string of the language with this grammar. This is the grammar for this A star. So now let us take A. How you can get A? So let us take this. Let us start with the start symbol. Here our start symbol is A. So let us take A and replace A with this production. So this is A and this is A. Now replace this A with this production again, so it will be A and A. Now replace this A with this A goes to epsilon, so it is epsilon. Now what is the yield of the tree? Is leaf of the tree. So your yield of the tree will be A and A. This way you have got this string. You can get any string with this grammar. Now let us see, if you want to take epsilon, you can use A goes to epsilon production. So you'll get this epsilon. If you want to A, this string to be generated by this grammar, so you can use start with a start symbol A and replace A with A. So this is A and this is A. Now replace this A with this epsilon. A goes to epsilon, so this is epsilon. So this is your string A. So this is the way to get the entire string of the language with this grammar. This is the grammar. This is the only grammar which has two production rules. One is A goes to small a and capital A. Capital A goes to small a and capital A. Second production is capital A goes to epsilon. So how we can write the grammar for this language? What will be the language? The language will be A plus B star. Means language will be language L. It will be epsilon. If you take a star as 0, clean closure as 0, your language will be, your string will be epsilon. If you take it 1, it can be A or B. If you take it 2, this means if you take a star as 2, then it will be A plus B and A plus B. So your language strings will be A from here and A from here. So your string will be like that. So your string will be A, B, B, A and B, B. So this will be your string. Now how can write the, we can write the grammar for this? So this is the language. This is the regular expression for that language. So what you can do? First you can write the grammar for A plus B. So what is the grammar for A plus B? Grammar for A plus B, let it be A. A plus B is capital A. So grammar for A plus B will be A or B. It is A plus B means A or B. So your grammar will be A or B for this thing, A plus B. Now, you have written the grammar for A star. In a similar fashion, you can write the grammar for A plus B star. So write the grammar for, let us start with S, and S goes to A and S. So this is the grammar for this. So we need epsilon also. So you can take S goes to epsilon. So this is the grammar for this language. Now let us see whether the grammar is correct now or not. For this you will have to take the strings of this language. Let us take any string. You can take any string. Okay. So let us take this string. Okay. This string can be generated by S goes to epsilon. Now let us take AB. So we will start with S and we will use AS. So A will goes to S will goes to again. So first you can replace A with A. This projection A with A. And S goes to again A and S. So take this as S as epsilon. S goes to epsilon. And take this A as A goes to B. A goes to B. This is A goes to B. So this is the, you will have to consider leaves only. So this is the yield of the tree. Means you have generated the spring AB. So this is the grammar for this and B. Now what will be the length? Length of a string is greater than equal to 2 and your terminals are A and B. So what will be your length? Your language will be, in that case, your regular expression for this language will be A plus B, A plus B, and A plus B star. So this will be your regular expression. Okay. Now I will write the grammar for this language. The language is represented by what? What can be the language? Language can be, if you see the actual language, length of a string should be equal to or greater than 2. So your language will be A, B, B, A, B, B, and A, B, or anything. This will be your actual language. This is the regular expression for this language. This language. Now, how you will write the grammar? So, if you identify the thing, this is the block you can identify. Okay. So, let us write grammar. Let it be B. So, it will also be B. So, let us first write for B. So, B goes to, it is A plus B, this means A or B. So, this is the grammar for this block. Okay. So, now you have to write the A plus B star. So, what is the way to write A plus star? A plus B star means A goes to B and A. So, whatever you will take here, this means you are taking the star of that. You are taking the star of that. You are getting the star of that with this grammar prediction. So, this is very important. Okay. So we have written the grammar for this A plus B and this A plus B and this B star. B star, your prediction will be A goes to B and A. Now, is it complete? Is it complete? No, it is not complete. But because it is B, B and B star. So it is S goes to B, B and A. So this is the grammar for this B star or A plus B star. So this is your grammar. Will this grammar be will be able to generate entire string of the language? Let us see. Take any strings. So you can take A from here. Okay. You can take B from here. Now you can take value of star B 2. So you will have 2 A plus B, A plus B. So take B from here and A from next A plus B. The string of this language. So can we get this string with this grammar? Let us see. So let us start with the start symbol S. So start symbol S. Okay. Now take B, B, A. Because you do not have any prediction, you have to follow this prediction only B, B and A. Now you need A here. So which prediction you will use? You can use this A. B goes to A. Now you have another B and you need four terminals. Okay. So you can take BA. So you need another B. So B moves to B, this prediction will be this. So B, A, B, B, A. This is this. So this is your grammar for this language. Your entire language. The language is finite language. The regular expression for this language will be A plus B plus epsilon. So this will be your regular expression for this language, A plus B plus epsilon. Now let us take, can we generate the entire string of this language with this regular expression? So if you would like to generate this AB, how you can generate the A from here and B from here? Okay, so this is actually A or B or C, A union B or union C. So you can take A from here and B from here, so you will get this string. So in a similar fashion you can get all the strings of the language. If you want to take epsilon, how you can take epsilon? Take epsilon from here and take epsilon from here, and finally you will get the epsilon. So this way you can get any string of the language. Now you want to take A from, so I take epsilon from here and A from here. So it will be A. So this way you can generate entire string of this language. This is the regular expression for this language. Now we have to write the grammar for this language, and we are having the regular expression. So we can write the regular grammar with the help of regular expression. Okay. So let us take this as a block. So what is the let it be A and A. So what will be the grammar for this A? A goes to small a, this means or, this B, and this is also or epsilon. So this is the grammar for this portion of the entire grammar. So this is the grammar. Now we are having S A two times. So A goes to A and A. So this is the grammar for this language. Now let us take any string, can we reach at this string with this grammar? So let us take this string BA. Okay. So S goes to A, S goes to capital A. Okay, S goes to A. We have used this prediction. Now we need BA. So this A will use this prediction, A goes to B. And this A will use this prediction as A goes to A. So this is your yield of the tree, and this is the desired string which you wanted. So this is called derivation tree or parse tree. Later at the end, derivation tree is to get the string of the language. Now let us take another language. The language is your terminal is A and B, or your sigma is A and B. It can be sigma also. It is also called sigma. So this is your terminal. Now the language is A. A string starts with A and ends with B. So this is the language. So it is A plus B star and B. So this is the language represented by this regular expression. Okay. So the language is what? Strings will start with A and end with B. In between these two, anything can be. So this is the language. Any combination of A, B. So how you can write the language for that? Let us start with S and A. Let it be capital A. So A and this B will come. Now we have to write this grammar for A plus B star. So first we'll have to write the grammar for A plus B. So let us take B. B goes to A or B. Okay, so suppose this, you have to write the grammar for this thing, A plus B whole star. So first you have taken A plus B. So grammar for A plus B will be B goes to A or B. And now take A goes to this B and A. This is the thing. Moreover, you will take epsilon also. Why we have taken A goes to epsilon? Because A star can be 0. So we have taken epsilon also. A goes to epsilon. So this is the graphite, the desired graphite. Now let us take. Can we generate the any string of this language? What will be the, let us take any one string of this language. So string can be A. Let us take star B 1. So you can take B. Or let the star be 2. So in 1A plus B, we can have B, A plus B, and A plus B, and B. So this A will come from here. This B comes from here. Star is equal to 2. So your string will be, this is A. A plus B, I have taken B. This A plus B, I have taken A, and this. So this is the string. So you wanted this string to get from this grammar. How we can get it? So obviously you have to start from S. So let us take A, capital A and B. Now, which production you must you will have to use? Let us use this production BA. So A goes to B and A. Now you need B and A. So B goes to B. Now you need A. So which production will you use? You will use B again. So this is B and this is A. Now you need this A, B and B. And you need this A. Okay. So B goes to A will be used. And A goes to epsilon will be used. So this is the end of your tree. So it is A. A is here. This is B. B is here. This is again A. It is here. This is epsilon. It doesn't matter. Then B, we have B here. So this is called derivation tree or parse tree. Now let us take another grammar. Grammar is, so how can we write the grammar for this language? Let us see. So this is, I believe this is the building block. So first you will have to write the grammar A plus, now let us take A plus B and B. So how can we write the grammar for this? Let it be B and B star. Okay. This is A B plus B. This is again B star and this is A. Okay. This is A. So first we'll write the grammar for A plus B. We have written the grammar for A plus B. So this will be the grammar production for this A plus B. Now this is A plus B star. Okay, so let it be A goes to A, and if you write B here, this means B star. So B is what? B is A plus B. So A plus B star. So this is the way to write the grammar. So this is your prediction. Now, what you are having? You are having A, okay, S goes to A, B star. For B star, what you will write? B star, what you will write? For B star, the star will take A. And this is A. And this is for OR. So take OR. This is B. For B star, you have A. And for this, we will come here. So this is the grammar for this language. So let us see. It is, star can be 0 also. Okay. So A goes to B and A goes to epsilon, you have to consider the case when star will have the value 0. So A goes to epsilon, production will also be considered. So this is the grammar for this language. Okay. Now let us take any string of the language. So you will have to take either this or that because it is an union. So let us take this. So your string can be B and any combination of A and B, let us take A, B, A and this B. So how we can generate this string with this grammar, let us see. Let us start with S and we will have to take which one, we will have to take this one. Okay. Because here B, 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 D are there. So B, A, B, so let us take B, A and B. Now, what will which protection will be used? Obviously, this protection only will be used. You will not use epsilon because you are having this thing A, B, A. So, B, A goes to B, A will be used. So, B, A. Now, you need A, B, A. Okay. So, one more times you will have to use this A goes to B. Finally, what you need? You need A, B, A. So your this B will goes to A. Now you need A, B. So this B will goes to B. Now you need A. So this A will again goes to B and A. Okay. So B and A. Now you need this A. So B goes to A will be used. Now you need nothing, you need nothing, so you can use A goes to epsilon. So this A will goes to epsilon. So what is the yield of the tree? Leaves of the tree are yield of the tree. So this is B, this is B, and this is A, this is B, this is A, this is epsilon, and this is B. So this is this B is this, A is here, and this B is here, and this A is here. And epsilon doesn't matter with this string, so B is here. So we have got this string of this language from this grammar. And this is called derivation tree or parse. This is the thing. Now another interesting question is that, is it complete? The grammar is complete for that? String starts and end with the same symbol, can be A also. Can be A also. A is the string which starts with A and ends with A. So this string must be considered. And B also be considered because it starts with B and it ends with B. You'll have to consider moreover epsilon also. So this grammar is not yet complete. To complete this grammar, you will have to take this A, S goes to A directly, and S goes to B, and you will have to take S goes to epsilon also. So now the grammar is complete.